If you could please introduce yourself, please.
My name is Sidney Jafta.
And what do you do?
I'm currently self-employed or unemployed.
So when you say you're self-employed, Mr. Jafta, what is it that you do?
I'm a small farmer.
What do you farm? What do you farm?
Farming with pigs.
You farm with pigs?
Pigs, pigs, goats, and sheep, and ducks.
So, is farming something that you grew up with, or is it something that you were brought into?
My grandfather used to be farming with animals, and I actually recently came from Johannesburg, and I'm here nearly 2 years at home, and I started to do farming.
Okay, so can you please just describe just the day on the farm, a day with your animals from when you wake up? What do you do with your animals? How does the day go about, you know, as
in the morning when I wake up, I start my vehicle and then I went to my to the camps, and then I look at my animals. If all of them fine, are fine. And after that, I'm the only person who feed my young pigs and goats, because I attend to them only. But I also attend to the bigger animals. But the guys who works for me, they attend to the bigger animals.
So, Meneer Mus, you said that you came from Joburg and then you came into farming. So
I was born in Grabrenet.
Okay.
I was born in Grabrenet. I was in Joburg for 30 years. So I came home. I decided to come home to look after my mother.
Okay.
So then I got interested in farming.
Okay. So now that you've been in farming, how are you finding it easy now to access farming, to get into the farming?
There's a lot of obstacles. At the moment, we're farming on a piece of ground that is not your property.
Okay.
It's not your property. We are a group of people that we actually established. And at the moment, we are busy negotiating with the council for property, or make the property our own. And we also even prepared to pay a little for water and whatever we can.
Okay, so now I want to know from you, Meneer, in terms of the whole this land debate, right? Where does Meneer stand in terms of the land debate that's going on in the country right now?
Yes, I saw that, you know, our people need land. Our people need land, and there's a lot of people, especially white people, who got land that they took from our people. And I feel that they need to share that land so that our people also can have land to farm on.
Yeah, because I also, you know, for me as well, I also feel that, you know, why should they have like 12 farms and why should one person have 12 farms all the time? Because I always ask my dad, I always ask him, like, when he speaks about my great-grandfather and all those people, he always says like that we had farms and stuff, and then but then came that act, and then we were taken away, and then that's how we lost how we get into farming. So now, how are we going to get back into the farming? So even some people say that even if we take the land, they say that we're going to do nothing with the land. We're not good farmers anymore, you know. So how do we get people back interested into? Because we need to feed our people.
Yes.
Like for me, that's how I feel. Like farming is all about feeding the nation.
The nation is.
Yeah, it's all about feeding the nation. So how are we going to get people back into farming? How do you believe that we can get people interested in farming?
It's very easy. You know, there's people who got farming in their blood. But you also got two different type of people. At the moment, you've got people who got land, but they don't make use of the land. There is instances that people got land which was very profitable, and they neglected it. And I also say that I think there's maybe different reasons why the land was being neglected.
Mm.
There's different reasons. We also have to look in why that land is neglected. Maybe, you know, sometimes is you give people land and then they don't appreciate the land. It's like the same you give your son a car and he doesn't appreciate it. I believe in that you have to work for things you want in life. And if you give things to a person easily, that person won't work on it. But if that person works for it, at the end of the day he can own it, and then his children and his grandchildren can also have access to that land. But at the moment we don't have access to land. So, and the government, there's a lot of land in South Africa. And there's land that is standing empty. Why can our people don't get that land? And the government can help us to build successful farms on that land.
No, Munir, thank you for your statements and for your advice. Thank you.
Thanks.